average. For subset. Oh, I need a name for this diagram. I'll call this extended Dingin diagram. I'll call it E. So in other words, you're in the monster. This subgroup might be very complicated, but if you choose this correctly, then for all choices of x and y and appropriate z, this is a group that looks kind of like the corresponding thing in Lie theory. So let me give one example. Let's say x and y have a product in this class 3C. So x and y can have product with any of these. Now take this diagram. This is where 3C lives. Cross it off. And what remains is type A8. The mild group of type A8 is the symmetric group of degree 9. The mild group of type AN is the symmetric group of degree n plus 1. That's a general fact. Okay, so if you take this centralizer and we factor out a normal 2 subgroup, it's a very big subgroup of the order of power of 2. We get the alternating group of degree 9. So that's roughly speaking 1/2 of the bio group. And if you take a walk among all the nodes, it's a very similar story. For instance, if you cross off this node, 6, 7, 8, let's cross off this node. This is the 5A node. What's left is A4. A4. The mild group of type A4 is the symmetric group of degree 5. So this thing, mod something, which I won't explain to you, looks like it's not quite this. But you have to sort of take half of the subgroup of index 2. It's really quite amazing. When you take a walk through all these nodes, and we found one case where it wasn't true. But it's true in all the other cases. Okay, so let me just completely here by just saying we used a lot of BOA theory to connect these two theories. We can actually take a walk through a whole series of objects, start here and come out with something that corresponds to an appropriate number here. And the last thing I want to mention is that in about 2007, I heard that Edward Whitman was looking at sporadic groups, and he was interested in three-dimensional gravity, and he found a bunch of possible algebraic objects that model some of these theories, and I don't know whether this theory is interesting anymore, but of these theories, the only one that was known to definitely exist was the one attached to the monster in this moon chunk theory. So it would be nice if sporadic groups helped to explain the structure of the universe, but they don't have to be left for another lecture and another lecture. Okay, I think that's all.
Any questions?
Is there any moonshine coming for those three sporadic groups in this particular case? Yes. I said there's similar stories here. Over here. Yeah, for instance, the E7 extended diagram, 4, 5, 6, 7, looks kind of like that. And if you have, you put, there are similar numbers there.
Oh, this is connected to the baby monster.
Right,
okay.
So it's not that one. It's, I think it's E6, right?
Yeah, E6 is the picture.
3, 4, 5. That's regular E6 diagram. The extended one looks like that. And these numbers are 1, 2, 3, 2, 1, 2, 1. And you get something that looks like the three transpositions in that sporadic Fisher group, Fisher 24.
Other questions?
Okay. Okay, if not, then let's give up.